Next man up, having that mentality as a group. So it's no surprise that these guys has not dropped off too much from injuries and stuff like that. Next man up type of mentality for those guys, and that's no surprise to me.
What's unique to what they do?
I mean, they play the way they want to play. Which what I mean by that is they play with it. They're playing the same way. No team can really speed them up, so break their rhythm as much as possible, but at the same time, they want to play the same pace, same way, move the ball the same way. I mean, that's what makes them effective. All five guys are a threat, and it's tough to guard.
Do you see their system is pretty similar to here?
Yeah.
What ways?
In the ways of this, all five guys is being a threat. We're always trying to make each guy a threat on the court, and that makes a defense very tough to defend those guys. And with everybody being live to score the ball and make a play, pretty tough to defend.
What about your role in that, in terms of, are you getting a bigger role in here than you were in Boston?
I mean, it's growing. I don't know the whole playbook like I did in Boston, so my touches and stuff like that are limited, but at the same time, it's coming along very well. I'm getting very acclimated with the system, but I knew it was going to take time.
Off the dribble, how are you developing those kind of reads that you're making off the world dribble handoff?
Yeah, I mean, I've always been afraid to use my head on the court, so that's coming pretty natural to me. But as more I get in those situations in the game, the better I get with it, especially within the system of Coach Snyder's system. So I think just with time, the reps, that'll get better.
Coaches have said that if guys touch the ball offensively, they play better defensively. Both Boston and Utah are elite defensive teams that share the ball offensively. Do you think it's related?
Numbers don't lie. Numbers don't lie at all. Go back to what I just said. All five guys been a playmaker, being able to shoot the ball, being able to pass, dribble. Just makes it tougher. It makes guys more into the game, more involved. And it does waver your, I guess it does waver your interest on the defensive end a little bit.
You know, the last time I understand, Quinn was talking about the mental fatigue of playing every other day, and like, yeah, there's always another game, and sometimes you lose an edge. Do you feel like maybe between that San Antonio OT game and the Warriors game, you might have gained that back a little bit?
It was a tough trip for us in that aspect of gaining what we needed to gain for each game. The San Antonio game was a back-to-back for us, and it did extend it over time. So that, I think, fatigue played a little factor in that a little bit. But at the same time, we put ourselves in position to win the game out there in San Antonio. But we did get a chance to get out to San Francisco and regain our focus a little bit and focus in on those guys. Not such a quick turnaround, but at the same time, it's part of the NBA schedule. So we have to be better at I think we did a good job putting ourselves in the game in San Antonio. It just didn't fall our way. But I think we did relocate and readjusted our mindset a little bit and focused in on San Antonio.
When you look at the last when you look at the last eight games, like, what sort of the minimum you want to have achieved in each game? Like, what it would be a success if we play good defense or if we had a close game?
I mean, defense, we should bring every night. We shouldn't have any lapses like defensively that we don't want to have. Of course, through the course of a game, you're going to have some, but to look back in a whole game and say defense wasn't there, it's not something that we want to be a part of. But I guess the way we approach the game and how we start the game and how we finish the game is pretty big. And responding to runs, I think when you're on the road, you have to respond to a run. The home team's going to go on a run, and a good ball club responds to a run with a run of his own. So I always look at it like that. And always giving ourselves a chance to win on the road is one or two possession game is always giving ourselves a chance to bring it up.
Rip Carlisle the other day called you one of the most resourceful players he's ever coached. Does that vibe with what you think of yourself as a player?
A little bit, yeah. I think that's what I bring to a team. I think I'm not too fond about stats and stuff like that. I always want to win. I've always been a winner. Always want to win. Always want to win the drill. Always want to be the first in winning something, you know what I mean? So I always try to prepare myself to to win a game, to win a practice, to win a drill. I think that's sort of kind of comes with a mindset a little bit. My mindset is geared that way. And it's just part of my DNA at this point.
Kyle mentioned, like, if you evaluate yourself as a team, what are you looking for? When you watch yourself on film, what do you watch for?
Obviously, I watch on different reasons I can get better with the ball in my hands, how I can present myself to teammates on giving them an open outlet on the offensive end. When Donovan dribble drives to the rim, how can I, if he gets there and has nothing, how can I help him out? Stuff like that. Just different reasons within our offense of where I can pick and choose to get better. And defensively, just continuing to learn different calls and stuff like that on the defensive end and reacting to them instead of thinking on the court. And just trying to make it a reaction type game for me, and that's when I plan to see it as possible.
One last thing, how are you liking Salt Lake City so far?
I mean, I like it so far. I mean, to be honest with you, I haven't gotten out to do anything. I'm a homebody when the season is going. So when the season is done, I'll get out here a little bit. But I stay at home. I watch a lot of basketball. I play with my daughter. I don't do too much.
When's your dad coming?
My dad's coming the last week of the last week. So when we get back from Minnesota, he'll be here.
Are you learning something when you're watching other games? Are you watching because you like the game, or are you trying to learn something?
Pretty much both. You never know who your opponent is. I watch a lot of West Coast games now, obviously, for the playoffs as well. So I'm just watching tendencies of players. You'd be amazed at how you can watch a game and learn tendencies, and when you come across a player, you don't even need the scouting report from the coach. You already know. It's already geared in your head because you've watched basketball, NBA basketball, so much. So that's why I watch it as a film type deal. And I watch it as a fan type deal as well, but mostly as a fan, prep myself.
Thanks, Jim.
You're welcome.
Thanks, Jim.